RTDS Technologies introduced the world's first fully digital real-time power system simulator in 1989. Today, the RTDS Simulator is still the world's benchmark for performing real-time power system simulation. RTDS Technologies leads the way with world-class in-house research and development, and a team committed to innovation and simulation support for our hundreds of customers around the globe. The RTDS Simulator changed the way protection and control system testing is performed for the entire power system industry, and continues to redefine the cutting edge of power system simulation. Today, the RTDS Simulator is used in over 40 countries by all of the world's major power system equipment manufacturers, leading electrical utilities, cutting-edge research institutions and universities, and consultants. The RTDS Simulator consists of custom hardware and software specifically designed to perform real-time electromagnetic transient simulations. This fully digital parallel processing hardware architecture is capable of simulating large and complex networks in real time. The RTDS Simulator has been developed to suit a wide variety of power system applications, such as the closed-loop testing of protection systems, including IEC 61850 communication, control system testing, including HVDC and FACS scheme simulation and testing, the simulation and testing of phaser measurement units as part of wide area measurement, protection and control schemes, smart grid and distributed generation studies, power hardware in the loop studies, large-scale power grid simulation for system restoration and utility operator training, and for student use in undergraduate and graduate level laboratories. The RTDS Simulator runs electromagnetic transient simulations based on the Dommel algorithm. The Dommel algorithm converts differential equations to linear algebraic equations using the trapezoidal rule of integration. This allows all elements within a given network to be represented by an equivalent current source and conductance. During each time step, the RTDS Simulator's parallel processing architecture uses this algorithm to carry out its power system solution process. First, a user-defined power system is converted to an equivalent network of only current sources and resistors, and a conductance matrix is formulated for this equivalent network. The RTDS Simulator's processor cards then calculate the equivalent conductance and current contributions associated with each of the components in the user's network and send them to the network solution processor, which is then responsible for calculating the voltages for the network. The voltage data is then passed back to the auxiliary processor cards so they can compute their current injections and conductance values for the following time step. This process is repeated in each and every time step. The parallel processing required to perform all of these calculations is carried out on processor cards. These cards perform the necessary calculations in parallel and exchange data over a communication backplane to which they are all connected. The cards are mounted in card cages known as racks, which are in turn housed in cubicles, along with auxiliary equipment for interfacing the RTDS simulator with external devices. This modular hardware architecture allows each RTDS simulator to grow in size if simulation needs increase. The RTDS simulator's custom-designed input-output cards communicate with the simulator via fiber optic cable and provide optically isolated analog or digital output and input for interfacing with external equipment. The cards can be DIN rail mounted in the back of the simulator cubicle or can be located in a separate lab with the user's external equipment up to hundreds of feet away. Other specialized hardware for the RTDS simulator allows the user to communicate with external devices over various Ethernet protocols, synchronize the simulation time step to an external time reference, like a GPS clock, and to model modular multi-level converters and their controls. The user conducts and interacts with simulations on a PC workstation running the RTDS simulator software. The PC communicates with the RTDS simulator's GTWIF workstation interface card over a local area network. The GTWIF card coordinates communication between the user's PC and the simulator hardware, sending and receiving messages associated with plot updates and other user-initiated events. The GTWIF card also coordinates data and communication between processor cards participating in the simulation. For multi-rack simulation cases, it coordinates data communication and synchronizes the simulation time step between different racks participating in the simulation. RSCAD, the RTDS Simulator's graphical user interface provides a facility for the user to build the simulation case and to run and interact with the simulation. RSCAD is a complete simulation solution. A license includes all software modules and component libraries. There are no add-on modules or options. The software was developed exclusively by RTDS Technologies and does not require third-party modules. The draft module allows the user to construct a simulation case using various component models available in the RSCAD libraries. The user can edit component parameters to define each element of the network. Once the network has been defined, the user compiles their case, which creates the executable code to be run on the RTDS simulator hardware. After a case is compiled, the runtime module is then used to start, stop, and interact with the simulation. Once the simulation is running, the user can change various parameters using switches, sliders, and push buttons, initiating faults and other events. Plotted data can be viewed and exported. Runtime also includes automation facilities, wherein the user can create a script file to execute many different simulation cases with minimal or no user interaction. RSCAD includes several other modules, including the facilities for defining the parameters of transmission lines and cables, and a tool for creating custom user-defined control and power system components. The RTDS simulator is used by practically all major manufacturers of protective relays for development and consumer acceptance testing. Here, we will demonstrate how the RTDS simulator can be used to perform basic hardware-in-the-loop testing with a distance protection relay. In this demonstration, we will send line voltages and currents as well as breaker status from the simulation to a physical relay outside of the simulation. We will connect breaker trip and reclose signals from the physical relay back into the simulation to close the loop. A simulation case has been developed in the draft module of RSCAD for testing the physical distance protection relay. The case includes a transmission line containing a fault branch, the position and resistance of which can be defined and varied by the user from the runtime module. Two circuit breakers isolate the line. On each end of the line are current transformers and capacitive voltage transformers to provide secondary level currents and voltages to protective relays. Circuit breaker 1 is controlled by a software relay, simulated in RSCAD. This distance protection module is available in the RSCAD component library. Circuit breaker 2 is controlled by the physical relay connected to the simulator. The analog output component defines the signals that will be sent out of the simulation via amplifiers to the relay. The digital to analog conversion is carried out by the RTDS simulator's GTAO card. In this case, the burden currents and voltages from the CTs and CVTs are the outputs. The front panel interface component is used to provide a digital interface to the relay. It defines signals to be communicated via the digital input and output panel mounted in the RTDS simulator cubicle. Here, the output contacts from the physical relay are used as input signals to control the software breaker. The high voltage panel component is used to define signals to be communicated via the high voltage digital output panel mounted in the RTDS simulator cubicle. This panel is capable of switching at station level voltage, and here it's used for breaker status signals. In this demonstration, the user can trigger a fault to check for the correct response from the physical distance protection relay. The voltages and currents will be sent out of the simulation via the RTDS simulator's GTAO card. The GTAO card features 12 optically isolated, 16-bit digital to analog conversion channels. The signals are sent from a PB5 processor card participating in the simulation to the GTAO card via fiber optic cable. The GTAO card has a maximum output range of plus or minus 10 volts peak. A power amplifier is used to scale up the output waveform and test the relay using its in-service operating voltages and currents. The GTAO outputs are connected to the amplifier's input channels, and gain levels are carefully set and tested to ensure that the amplifier's output values are as expected. The amplifier outputs are then connected to the protective relay's analog inputs. The protective relay's output contacts are connected to the RTDS simulator's digital interface panel to communicate breaker commands. The simulator's high voltage panel is connected to the relay's input channels to communicate breaker status. In this way, we've created a closed loop between the RTDS simulator and the protective relay. Once our hardware is set up and everything is configured properly in our software, we can compile our case and open the runtime console to start our simulation. From the runtime module, the user can adjust which phases are faulted, as well as the fault's position on the line and the duration, resistance, and fault inception angle. When ready, the user can press the push button to activate their fault. This user can automate this process by generating a script file for batch mode testing and report generations for hundreds or thousands of test cases. After the fault is triggered, an inspection of the physical relay shows the expected response. In the software, we see the circuit breakers open accordingly, and we can view data describing the system's response before, during, and following the fault. Protection testing with the RTDS simulator can also be conducted using an IEC 61850 interface. The RTDS simulator's GTNet X2 network interface card allows the simulator to communicate with the physical relay using LAN-based protocols. As an alternative to using the GTAO card for analog output, the current and voltage signals from the simulation case could be sent to the relay using IEC 61850-9-2 sampled values data. The breaker commands and status could be communicated via IEC 61850 goose messaging. Protection system testing like this is just one of the many applications that the RTDS simulator is used for in over 40 countries around the world. To learn more about the world standard for real-time digital power system simulation, visit our website at www.rtds.com.